Hi guys! Hello grade 5! Welcome back to our science class. We are now on our last week 7 to 8 with our quarter 3 learner's packet, electromagnetism. Our most essential learning competencies, design an experiment to determine the factors that affect the strength of the electromagnet. Our core content, propose device using electromagnet that is useful for home, school, or community. In the previous lesson, you have learned that in a series circuit, electric current flows through a single pad. So when one bulb is loosened or busted, all the other bulbs in this circuit will not light anymore. The loosened or busted bulb breaks or opens the pathway, so electricity cannot flow through. And a parallel circuit, on the other hand, has light bulbs with different loops. Thus, each bulb is a part of a different circuit. When one bulb is loosened, taken, or burned out, the other bulbs still light up. This is because each bulb has its own pathway. This time, you will learn about electromagnetism. Look at the illustrations carefully. What can you see? So we have here an example of electromagnet. So what is electromagnetism? It is a study of electromagnetic force. Electricity and magnets are closely related to each other. Electricity can produce magnets, while magnets can produce electricity. This is a picture of simple electromagnet. It has parts, as you can see here. The coiled wire, iron needle, wire, battery, of course. So you're going to do that later on. A magnet is usually made of iron. It can attract objects such as pins, coins, and other materials made of iron and steel. A nail iron is not a magnet, but it can be turned into one. This is done by coiling a wire around it and then letting electricity flow through it. Doing this turns the nail into an electromagnet. An electromagnet attracts like a real magnet. It can attract materials made of metals like pins and thumbtacks. The iron nail acts as a magnet while electricity is flowing through the coil of wire, like this one in the video or GIF example. It attracts the pins. When electricity stops flowing through the coil to the nail, can the nail still attract the pin and the thumbtack? No, it can no longer attract the pin and the thumbtacks. Electromagnets are temporary magnets. When electricity stops flowing through a coil of wires, the nail stops attracting any metal or magnetic material. An electromagnet can be made stronger by using more coils of wire. Each turn of the wire adds more force to the electromagnet. The number of dry cells also affects the strength of electromagnet. More dry cells means more electrons flowing in the electromagnet, and therefore, stronger magnetism is produced. This is the coil. Okay, this is the dry cell. Magnets in different industries and businesses are usually used in electromagnet powered devices such as cranes, cutters, fax machines, computers, etc. Powerful cranes use electromagnets to move scrap iron and steel or separate metals for recycling. Just like this in the picture. This is the metal magnet crane that attracts the iron and steel and separate the metals for recycling. And generators in power plants rely on magnets like the ones found in electric motors to produce electricity. This is an example of generator, and this one is the transformers. You can see this in the Meralco post. Just notice those transformers at your Meralco post. So transformers, devices that use electromagnets to change high voltage electricity to low voltage electricity or vice versa. They are often used at homes and in offices. Some transportation systems use magnets too. Trains, subways, trolleys, and monorails are examples of this. Scientists and engineers have even developed maglev trains, which use electromagnets to float above the tracks. This then eliminates friction, which helps the train run faster than ordinary trains. This one in the picture is an example of maglev train that was used in other nations like China or Japan. So here we go with our learning task number one. Let us help Ellie and Maggie collect objects which are needed to make an electromagnet. Let us encircle the objects. So here in the picture, we're going to help Ellie and Maggie to help collect objects which are needed in their project electromagnet. So here's the bigger picture. So we're going to help Maggie and Ellie to collect what they will need with their electromagnet project. So for the first one, we have the battery holder, and of course it is connected with the alligator clip. Then as we go through here, we have the copper wire, the 3 meter copper wire. And as we go through here, okay, we also need these clips. And as we go there, we also need this dry cell for our electromagnet. And for the last one, we have for the core of the electromagnet that they are going to do, we have the nails or the nail. Okay, these are the things that you are going to be to need when you are going to do your electromagnet. So here are some questions for the activity. Explain why Ellie and Maggie should use those materials for their electromagnet. Okay, those materials that we have encircled a while ago, please explain why they should use those. And number two, how will they test the strength of their electromagnet? With the materials they gathered, how will Ellie and Maggie increase the strength of their electromagnet? How will they remove the things which will stick to the electromagnet? And number four, will they get the same result if they will use the other materials in the maze? Okay, you're going to answer those questions after answering the activity. Don't you worry, we have sample answers in the last part of this video. Okay? The activity that you are going to perform will clearly determine the factors that affect the strength of the electromagnet. We have here the learning task number 2. Prepare the materials listed here. If not available, you may use other materials at home to perform the activity. You may ask the help of your parents, guardians, or any adult members of the family if needed. Okay, these are the materials. 1 battery, electrical wire, thumbtacks, 1 large iron, nail, and pins. This one. They are here in the picture, the pins or clips that are made of metal, the iron nail, the electrical wire, and the battery. Here are the procedures. Please note that make sure that the iron nail does not have any rust. Be careful in handling materials. You may use new iron nail so that it will not have any rust. Number 1, make an electromagnet by winding the electrical wire around the large nail. Connect both ends of the wire to a dry cell. Test the electromagnet by placing some pins and thumbtacks near the nail. Does the nail attract the pins and thumbtacks? Loosen the coil of wire in the electromagnet and find out how many metals are attracted to the nail. Now, wind more coils of wire which set up attract more metals. Add more dry cells to the electromagnet. Make sure you connect the dry cells properly, which set up attracts more metals. Change the nail into smaller one, which set up attract more metals. So you have to do this activity so that you can get the correct answer. Okay, these are now the questions that you're going to answer after performing the activity. What is the effect of the following variables on the strength of an electromagnet? Here are the things: tightness of the wired coils around the nail, number of coils wire around the nail, number of dry cells used, and the size of the nail. Number 3, learning task. Inside the box, list down appliances that are commonly used at home. Put a check mark on the appliances where electromagnetism is applied. Choose 1 appliance from your list and explain how electromagnetism is applied. Okay? And for the learning task number 3, draw a device using electromagnet. Then explain how it can be useful for home, school, or community. Consider the rubric in your learner's packet. And for our assimilation part, what is electromagnetism? It says here, electromagnetism is the study of electromagnetic force. It can be made stronger by using more coils of wire. It can attract materials that are made of metals like pins and thumbtacks. It attracts like a real magnet, temporary magnet. Okay, so those are electromagnetism. And for our last learning test, read each item carefully. Choose the letter of your answer. So you may read it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then write the letter of your answers. Here are some sample answers only. So we have here the activity number 1, sample answers. You may pause the video so that you can read it. and for the next activity. And for the next one. And for the drawing, you may draw like this one in my example, or you may draw anything else that you want, that it is using electromagnet, device that is using electromagnet, then explain how it can be useful for home, school, or community, like this one in my sample answer. I chose lighting or the lighting system. And for the assessment, here's the answer. And thank you so much for listening. Hope you learned something from my discussion. If you have questions, suggestions, clarification, you may comment down below. Don't forget to like and share and ring the bell for notifications for something that is coming up. Thank you. God bless.